Hey guys, how's it going? Hope everybody's doing really well out there today. Here recently, there was an app that came across my radar called Termix. Now, I think it actually originally showed up on Reddit when I was scrolling through that the other day, but I'll be damned if I can find it. Even searching Reddit, Termix is like, hey, did you mean Termux? No, I didn't mean Termux. I click Reddit, Termix. I get a lot of other stuff, and this is all a Mac-related app, which is different, I think. I don't know, but when I was doing the live stream just a few minutes ago, we took another quick look at Termix because it also showed up in the self-host newsletter last Friday, the 7th, I believe. So anyway, we took a quick look through that newsletter and this popped back up on my radar and I wanted to take a look at it and share it with you guys. So I guess with that little introduction out of the way, let's take a look at what Termix is, what it does, take a look at their GitHub and take a look at getting Termix installed. So this is Termix. This is an SSH terminal window in a browser. This is self-hosted via Docker on the mini PC that's in the rack behind me. And here we can see that I am connected to 192.168.0.207. And from here, you know, I can just do whatever I need to do via my terminal window very easily as if I was plugged directly into it. Or of course, look, this is on Proxmox, so I could just do it over here as well. But for those people who don't want to use Proxmox or are looking for an SSH solution to manage their servers via the browser like this, Termix is actually a pretty cool option. So this is for my Arugo setup, right? We can see Arugo's in the name there, but we can also see that Arugo is right up here. And you'll notice to the left of that, we've got Bezel Hub, Bezel Agent, and Termix LCS. I did that wrong. But what's cool about this is I can just toggle between them. I can jump back and forth between different instances that I've got currently up and running via my SSH solution here. Now, what's cool about this is that if I wanted to, say, add or have Bezel Hub and Arugo side by side, I can do that. I can have those right there next to each other. Or if I wanted to add a third or even a fourth window here and jump between them back and forth as I'm doing different things, maybe I'm doing a quick server maintenance kind of thing, and I just want to have four windows up and run these commands kind of all simultaneously, this is a very cool way to do it. And if I wanted to, I can come back through and I can just manually turn off the ones that I don't need at any given point, just with a couple of clicks. And now we're back to Bezel Hub as my primary window here. Very straightforward stuff. Again, I can do, you know, just app, oops, wow, if I could spell app update, cool, just like that. And now I'm updating the LXC that's in that server behind me just that quickly and easily. I can do all of my management stuff from right here. If I'm done, let's say with Bezel Hub, just close it and it's gone. The connection's lost and it's no longer part of what's going on here. Now, a couple of things. First, this is still in very, very early development. I want to say that. So if we actually jump over to the GitHub repository, again, this will be linked in the video description. We can see everything that's going on here. We can see that Termix is an open source, forever free, self-hosted server management panel. Now, this may seem somewhat familiar because this is absolutely inspired by NextTerm. We can see that right there. They've got it in there. I appreciate their transparency in that. As it says here, as I was kind of alluding to a moment ago, this app is in very early stages of development. Expect bugs, data loss, and unexplainable issues. For that reason, I recommend that you securely tunnel your connection to Termix through a VPN. So probably don't make this publicly accessible just yet, unless you're very, very good at securing your connections. This is kind of a local use only thing at the time of recording this video, March 11th, 2025. I would just probably not put this public facing in any capacity at this point, unless you're very, very good at locking things down with your VPN, your remote proxy, whatever, your reverse proxy, whatever the case is. Be very, very cautious about that. If you give somebody access to this, they could wreak havoc on your system. Now, that said, currently the features that are involved with it or set up with this, again, at the time of recording, is SSH and split screen up to four screens simultaneously and a tab system. And we've seen that. We saw all of that in action, right? Now, there are planned features. There are things that are coming. like a database to store connection details so that you don't have to manually type things in every time you want to do that. We'll take a look at that in a minute as well. Because when I connected all of this stuff, like I had to come up here to the top right, click that, put in the host name. The host name was kind of irrelevant, but just to let you know what it is, IP address, the user, the authentication, do you want to do password or an SSH key, an RSA key? You can select either of those and put in the relevant information there. Select your host port and click add and you're done. Then it shows up right here in your list of compatible things. But once you close these out, that's it. There is none of that has been stored, right? So I actually kind of appreciate that security. That said, though, coming back over here to the planned features, they are planning on eventually adding a database to store connection details. They're also looking at adding VNC, RDP, SFTP, ChatGPT with a Llama integration for commands, a login screen, user management, and apps like Notes, AI, etc. And in fact, if we jump back over to here, we can click the little airplane icon there, and there's where Launchpad will be in the future at some point. It's just not there yet. So I'm going to go ahead and click close right there. That's the app. Like, that's it. Like, you can just come up here and you can connect to something via this and have multiple tabs or multiple windows open simultaneously in kind of a four-panel configuration for whatever you happen to be doing at the time. And jump back over to the GitHub repository for just a moment here. There's an installation section right here where you can visit the Termix Wiki for more information about how to install Termix. You can also use these links to go directly to the guide, which I appreciate. So, oops, we're going to pop both of those open. So this is it. This is the Docker command line. This, if you want to run a Docker run, you can do it that way, or you can use a Docker compose and do it that way. There are a couple of different ports available. Port 8080, which is for the Nginx web app, which is the front end. And then there's this port for SSH web socket that doesn't need to be opened, but it's there if you want to open it up. Very, very straightforward. We'll take a look at deploying that in just a moment. And then there's the manual on how you can deploy it a different way if you want to go that route. If we jump over to, oh, I don't have that open. Oh, that seems like some stuff I would do here. You know what? I can just do this. It's 181, and then we'll do 9443, right? Just to get into Portainer. Right, so here we are. We're in Portainer. Let's open this up. Let's take a look. We can see I've got Termix app running right there. And if we look at the stack, it's just like what we saw. You can just copy and paste that in there. Adjust the ports as necessary. If you're already using port 8080 for something, you can just change the first half to like 9494, right? And then you can click update the stack and click update or deploy. If it's your first time deploying this, and we'll give this a second to deploy. And now we're on 9494 that we can see right there. And if I click that, hey, look, there we go. So what I want to point out, and they've already made reference to this, is that there isn't any sort of database to store any of your connection details. This is very much a first run instance, just to kind of a proof of concept. Very, very early development in this, again, like we talked about a moment ago. So be very careful with this. The reason I'm showing it is because I like these apps. I like an app that does one thing really, really well. And this appears to do one thing really, really well. It doesn't store any data. It lets you connect to a remote server via SSH, as long as that server has the capacity to be connected to via SSH. It allows you to get in and do updates and install stuff and do what you need to do, and then terminate that connection. And it's actually pretty secure because there's no there's nothing that's being stored in this. The one thing I actually haven't looked at yet, let's see, yeah, server ports running on 8081. It's not actually storing any information there. So let's do one more thing here. Let's come over, this is on 181. So what I want to do is I want to just create this. I'm going to do tutorial, host IP, root user. My authentication method is going to be password. And then I can select the host port. If that's different, you can change it. Mine's just 22, so I'm gonna click on add. There we go, just that quick and easy. There was no edit there, there was no cut. It just really popped up that fast. So absolutely love all of that. So I wanted to show this because it is in early development. I wanted to show this because I like what the developer is doing here. And the project only has 70 stars at the moment. So if you like this and you'd like to support the developer in some capacity, bare minimum, go give them a star. Maybe watch the project so you can be kept up to date as far as what's going on with new releases and that sort of thing. We can see the newest release was 2 days ago right there. If you can contribute, cool. If not, you can do very, very simple things to support them. I'm really excited to see where this goes, especially because they've mentioned that this is supported or not supported, influenced by next term. I lost my brain there for a second, but I'm always interested in these kinds of things to make management of servers easier. So let me know what you think about Termix in the comments section down below. I'd love to hear what your thoughts are there. Again, links to all of this will be in the video description also down below. And then I'm going to go edit this video so I can give my brain a break because I can't seem to pronounce words anymore. So anyway, I hope you liked the video. Hopefully I'll hear from you in the comment section down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll talk to you in the next video.